Ik kijk nog steeds naar MTV Nieuw vanuit Denemarken op het Roskilde Festival. Guys, you're here of course for your live performance tonight. Now we're going to shoot that as well.
Uh-oh.
So with the magic of TV, in a minute we're going to have a look at that performance.
Wow.
But how do you look forward to live performing in Denemark?
We get drunk, so we can look forward to it and hopefully make it to the stage.
How many times have you guys been here before?
This is our third time.
Yep. Just good feedback of Nordic countries.
Mm-hmm. That's lovely. Yeah, we love it.
Okay, the magic of TV. Let's have a look at the live performance. Deftones.
Oh,
she'll be here tomorrow. Oké, dan vandaag sta ik samen met de Deftones op het Roskilde Festival in Denemarken. Chino, now for the album, I think it was your second one, Around the Fur. You basically refer to PJ Harvey as one of your greatest inspirations for that album. Mm-hmm. How come though?
Just the fact that she can be the sweetest little thing in the world, and a minute later she'll be ripping you up in pieces. And I've always enjoyed that of her. You know what I mean? Of her, the way she writes, very intriguing. From the first record to the demos to everything. I mean, I've always been a big fan. I met her here the first time we ever played Roskilde. The first time I met her, and that, like, I fainted. These fools had to pour water on me. Think about it. I kick it with Madonna. I kick it with people who, like, people would, they would think.
PJ Harvey, you went all soft.
Man, and I'd be like, I was walking and I just fell. They pour water on me and shit. It was crazy.
Let's have a look at the nice looking lady. And the first band I bump into backstage, Deftones. Guys,
uh-oh,
thanks for the time.
Excellent.
Chino, how are you doing?
I'm good, man. What's up?
Well,
it's Romeo. Nice. What's up?
It's Romeo.
Guys, in a minute, I want to talk about your interest in PJ Harvey.
Of course, yeah.
Abe, your relationship to Incubus. And of course,
relations.
Of course, White Pony. But first of all, we're going to have a look at a video.
Okay.
Is it cool if we start off with Change?
Because that's sounds good.
Awesome video. Now, how was it? Who directed the video, by the way?
Liz Freelander.
How was it to shoot that video? Was it?
It was really fun, man. It was like being in a Calvin Klein ad.
Okay.
Well, no. Being the ugly members of a Calvin Klein ad.
Oh, that's how you consider yourself, right?
Yes.
Okay. Well, let's just have a look at the video. This is Change. Op het Roskilde Festival. Abe, I would like to talk a bit about Incubus, because I interviewed them a couple of weeks ago. Now, are you the drummer's brother?
Or yeah, little Mike is my younger brother.
Okay.
We've been brothers for about 26, 27 years.
Yeah. And you never kind of thought of, hey, let's get Incubus to do a support act for us or something?
We've done it in the States, yeah.
We did tour
the Incubus. Isn't their moms, like, they all came out, it was cool, like, yeah, you know.
She designs her outfits.
Came out, she cooked, they cooked for us every day.
Okay.
Yeah, it was really nice.
Actually, their mom is their stylist.
She right.
All their clothes.
You notice that they're kind of hip-hop fashion?
Yeah. They're very fashion.
Yes, they're very hip-hop.
Let's have a look at Incubus then.